In this lecture, we will consider our next conditional construct, that is switch. So let's get started. Now, what is switch? Switch is a great replacement to long else if constructs. Like for example, here you can see this is an example of a long else if construct. As you can clearly see, if x is equals to 1, then we simply print x is 1. Else if x is equals to 2, then we simply print x is 2. Else if x is equals to 3, then we simply print x is 3. Else we will print x is a number other than 1, 2 and 3. Now definitely writing down these else if constructs many number of times is quite cumbersome. So here is the good replacement, that is switch. We can replace all these else if constructs with this one switch construct. Now let's try to understand how switch construct is mimicking the behavior of these else if constructs. First, it checks if x is equals to 1 or not. That means whatever is there inside the switch is going to get compared with label 1. This is case label. Please note down that all the cases are checked from top to bottom. That is, this case is checked first and then this case is checked and then this case is checked. It first checks if x is equals to 1 or not. If x is 1, then simply this printf function will get evaluated. Otherwise, if x is not 1, then it checks if x is equals to 2 or not. If x is 2, then this printf function will get evaluated and so on. Now, if suppose none of the cases are satisfied, then the default statement will get executed. Now, please remember that default is optional. It is not necessary to add this default statement. If x is not equals to 1, 2 and 3, then simply default will get evaluated and the statement corresponding to that default, that is this printf function, will get evaluated. Now let's say suppose x is equals to 1, then definitely this printf function will get evaluated and it will print x is 1. After that, you can see there is a statement called break. Now suppose there is no break after this printf function, then subsequent expressions will also get evaluated until we reach the next break. Now what does it really mean? If suppose there is no break written immediately after this printf function, then the subsequent expression, that means this particular printf function, will also get evaluated even though x is not equals to 2. Therefore, it is important to put break immediately after this printf function if we want to get outside of the switch construct after evaluating this particular statement. Okay? Now break is also optional. It is not necessary to put break immediately after the expression. Now let's consider some important facts related to switch. Fact number 1. You are not allowed to add duplicate cases. That is, for example, here you can clearly see that you are repeating the cases, right? And hence, you will encounter an error, that is duplicate case values. So, avoid duplicating the cases. Let's consider the fact number 2. Only those expressions are allowed in switch which results in an integral constant value. That is, for example, here I have declared three variables a, b and c and I have assigned them values 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Now inside this switch you can see there is an expression a plus b into c which evaluates to 7 finally, right? Now because this expression evaluates to an integral constant and hence we can write this expression inside this switch. Now because 7 is not matched with 1 and 2, therefore default will get evaluated and hence the output is default, right? On the other hand, here I have declared 3 variables of float data type. And of course, this expression will evaluate to a float value, right? Now this is not allowed. As I already told you, only those expressions are allowed in switch which results in an integral constant value. Here it returns a float value, therefore it will simply produce an error. That is, switch quantity, not an integer. Okay, let's consider the next fact. Float value is not allowed as a constant value in case label. Only integer constants or integer constant expressions are allowed in case label. That is, for example, here you're putting a float constant value, which is not allowed, and hence it will produce an error. That is, case label does not reduce to an integer constant. On the other hand, if you simply put expressions like this, which finally results in an integral constant, is allowed. and hence it will produce a correct output. Here in this case, value of x is 23 and 4 into 5 is 20 plus 3 is 23. Therefore, this case will get evaluated correctly and choice 2 will get printed. Now let's consider the fourth fact. Variable expressions are not allowed in case labels. Like for example, here I have declared three variables x, y and z, and one of the case label is y and one of the case label is z. Now these are variables. As variable expressions are not allowed in case labels, therefore this particular program will produce an error. That is, case label does not produce an integer constant. Although macros are allowed. For example, here I have defined some macros like y and z, and we are using these macros as case labels, y and z here. These are not variables, these are macros. They are allowed. Therefore, this program will not produce an error and it will produce an output number is 2. Okay? Let's consider the fifth case. Default can be placed anywhere inside switch. It will still get evaluated if no match is found. For example, it is not always necessary to put default immediately after the cases. It can be put at the top, it can be put in the middle, but it will always get evaluated after checking all the cases. Okay? That means, first case 1 is checked, then case 2 is checked, then after default is checked. Here in this case, as x is equals to 2, therefore 2 is compared with 1 first. As 2 is not equals to 1, therefore this printf function will not get evaluated. But as we can clearly see, 2 is equals to 2, therefore this printf function will get evaluated and hence the output is number is 2. Okay? Even though default is placed at the top, but it will get evaluated only after evaluating all these cases. Please remember this point. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this lecture.